Mike Florio, NBC Sports Network, ProFootballTalk.com, and he joins us now on the program. There are so many questions. You better have answers for me, Mike.
I've got, can you handle the truth?
I can't handle the truth. I can handle the truth. Here we go. Alex Smith is going to where?
I'm suspicious. Anytime a team says we've got a trade lined up for a player, but we're not going to tell you who that team is, and there's no other team out there putting its hand up saying it's us. Because what's the reason at this point of the other team not disclosing that they've got the deal in place and they're going to get the deal done, unless they're concerned that someone else is going to swoop in and try to steal him, because none of this stuff is binding until March 12th. It just seems odd to me. I think the 49ers are trying to generate a trade market by pretending they have a deal done.
Well, it sounds like it's Kansas City. It's not Jacksonville, because I think Jacksonville makes a play for Matt Flynn, which would make more sense, but... If it is,
well, they're acting like they're all in on McLovin's boy, Blaine Gabbert. I still don't get it, but
no.
They're acting like they're all in on him.
And then I even heard somebody say if Blaine Gabbert was in this draft, he would be the first quarterback taken.
Of course, that doesn't say much about this draft. It may be entirely accurate. Well, that was somebody from the Jaguars who said that. So
you're right.
This is the time of year where you have to be ready to not believe anything you hear from any GM or coach or scout, because they want to keep their plans concealed. Because if their plans are known, then other teams are going to react and try to get the guys that they think that team may be trying to get.
Okay, best guess then. Alex Smith, he has to be dealt, because you can't have him over there on the sideline, and I think it still will stunt Colin Kaepernick's growth. You have to move him, given the price tag you have. I know you got a bargain in Kaepernick at $600,000, but where do you go, and is it, and what are you getting in return?
Well, I agree with you, Dan. Kansas City makes the most sense. Now, does he want to go there? I don't see why he wouldn't, because Jim Harbaugh and Andy Reid are the two best quarterback coaches right now in the NFL, and it was Harbaugh that got the most out of Alex Smith, and Reid would do the same thing. But if there's just a team Alex Smith doesn't want to play for, and the 49ers try to trade him there, that's not going to work either. And I think a mid-round pick is what would work, 3, 4, 5. Maybe fourth or fifth round is most realistic, simply because there aren't a whole lot of other options in free agency or the draft this year. Last year, Alex Smith was free and clear, unrestricted free agent, and he hung around for a week or so until he went back to San Francisco. There was no land rush for Alex Smith last year, and he had the best season of his career in 2011. So it just shows you how different it is this year without the supply of quarterbacks.
Yeah, and they're going to get rid of Matt Castle, so he would get to go in and be the starting quarterback for the Kansas City Chiefs. Talking to Mike Florio from ProFootballTalk.com. Manti Te'o, from all accounts, seemed to do pretty well with the question and answer session at the Combine. And more questions about him off the field or on the field as being a first-round pick?
Well, on the field, you still have to account for what happened in the BCS National Championship game against Alabama. And I admire him for not using all those distractions with the fake dead girlfriend as an excuse. He knew it was going to come out. It was weighing on him. He won't say that affected his play. And you know, maybe it did, but I respect him for saying that it didn't. Because if he did try to blame it on the play, we'd all be saying, oh, you're just making excuses. I mean, you got to put yourself in the position of this 22-year-old kid trying to deal with what he knew was going to be a firestorm once it all hit. But here's the elephant in the room for the teams. And it shouldn't matter, but we have to step aside from the rest of reality and walk into the industry, the unique industry that is the NFL. Teams want to know whether or not Manti Te'o is gay. They just want to know. They want to know, because in an NFL locker room, it's a different world. It shouldn't be that way.
Can you ask that question at the Combine?
I don't think you can ask that question because of the Dez Bryant question from a few years ago. Because if you go Katie Couric on Manti Te'o, then it's going to come out that some team, some GM, some coach asked Manti Te'o if he's gay. And then you're going to have to deal with all of the distraction and all of the stuff that flows after
that. Wait a minute,
but
Mike, you're telling me that you're hearing from teams who want to know this, but how do you ask it? Are they trying to find a finesse a way to ask that question, or are they going to do investigative work on finding out if Manti Te'o is gay?
It's been described to me as the proverbial elephant in the room, and I don't think anyone knows how to solve this dilemma yet. Because it's just that they want to know what they're getting. They want to know what issues they may be dealing with down the road. We've just assumed that at some point there would be an openly gay player in an NFL locker room, and the team would have to work with the realities and make sure that everything's fine. Now you've got a situation where you have a guy who was in a relationship with a fake girl who ended up being a real man, and the man has said to Dr. Phil that he was romantically in love with Manti Te'o, it just creates a lot of questions that, you know, the NFL at some point is going to have to deal with. But Tony Dungy makes a great point on this. If the NFL were ready for an openly gay player, there would be an openly gay player. That no one knows better the feel of the locker room than somebody who's in it. And if there's no one in any NFL locker room who is gay and is comfortable about coming out, the time's not right yet. And that just gets bundled up in these questions and issues. And I'm not saying that anyone would take Manti Te'o off the board if they suspect that he's gay or know he's gay. That's just the thing that's hanging out there that they want to know the answer to, and I think they realize there's no way to know.
And by all accounts, Manti Te'o is still going to be a first-round draft pick. I thought that it was interesting as well that Mac Barkley didn't throw, but it's as if he moved up on the draft. How the hell does that happen?
It's the smoke screen. The Cardinals all of a sudden are linked to this guy at number 7. They're falling all over themselves to tell reporters that they love Matt Barkley. I think they love Geno Smith. Because look at Bruce Arians, the head coach. Look at the quarterbacks he's had. Big, strong, and mobile. Barkley's big and strong, but not mobile. I think Bruce Arians wants Geno Smith, and they're getting the word out there on Matt Barkley so no one else gets in front of them to get Geno Smith.
Oh, my gosh. Joe Flacco update.
The Cleveland have been talking. They spent a lot of time in Indianapolis. But if they don't get it done by next Monday, Dan, I think what they're going to use is the non-exclusive franchise tag, which leaves that door cracked open for someone else to try to make a play. And they're going to hope that if the Browns or the Chiefs or the Bills or someone else makes a play, that Flacco will then take the offer back to the Ravens to give them a chance to match it before he signs it. Once he signs it, that's like activating the launch codes for the nuclear missile. Once that thing's signed, anything can happen.
Percy Harvin, should I stay, should I go? What's happening there?
Well, Percy's not talking. A reporter from Minnesota tracked him down at his house in Florida, and he wouldn't talk. Rick Spielman, the Vikings GM, continues to say, we have no intent of trading Percy Harvin. We have no intent of trading Percy Harvin. The reality is, if you're going to keep him, you better pay him like Larry Fitzgerald or Calvin Johnson, or he's going to hold out this year. So the Vikings have a mess. I think they'd love to have someone make them a significant offer for Harvin so they can move on, but I don't think it's going to happen.
Good stuff, Mike, as always. Thank you, sir.
All right, see you, pal.
Mike Florio, ProFootballTalk.com, NBC Sports Network.